Welcome to the Haas Tip of the Day. My name is Mark, and today we're going to show you the most important, key, critical, vital thing that you need to know when using macros on your Haas control. Now, I've written a short macro for us, and I've put that macro onto our control and onto our whiteboard. We're going to use macro variable 1128. For now, you just need to know that 1128 is tied to our high-intensity lights that are mounted on top of our machine. 1128 equals 0, our light's going to turn off. 1128 equals 1, our light should turn on. Now, in single-block mode, I expect that light to turn off and on each time the green cycle start button is pressed as we walk through the program line by line. Let's go to the control and see if it does what I intended. Now, the machine is in single-block mode. My program is loaded, and I'm going to press cycle start. Wait a second, the light turned on. I have not even gotten to my first line of code yet. Well, we'll keep going. Light off, light on, light off, light on. What's happening? Why did my light not turn off and on like I expected? Well, it's because the Haas control has superpowers. It can actually see into the future, and we call this look ahead. Now, look ahead is incredibly important for a Haas machine. With high-speed machining, the control looks ahead, kind of like a race car driver who's memorized the race car track. He knows exactly when to press on the brakes or hit the gas. The machine does the same thing. It accelerates and decelerates properly based on the upcoming moves. Now, with cutter compensation, the control looks ahead and calculates exactly where to go based on the current tool and work offsets. There's a lot of math happening. All this comes together to give us a smooth machining operation. Now, look ahead is incredibly important, but for the macro programmer, sometimes we have to limit that superpower for just a few lines of code. Now, we can do that in a couple different ways. The most common way is to use a G103 P1 in our program, followed by a few blank lines. And we'll drop that right in front of our macro statements. Now, what this does is it makes the control stop and think before going any further in the program. When we're done with our macro statements, we want to turn look ahead back on with a plain G103. Now, we know that cutter compensation needs look ahead. So if you try and run a G41, G42 cutter compensated move while in G103, you're going to get an alarm. I've added a G103 P1 to my program, which is going to modally block look ahead. I've turned single block on, and we're going to try this experiment again. I'm going to press cycle start. I'm walking through my program. Light's not on, that's a good sign. Light on, hey. Light off, light on, G103, which turns look ahead back on, M30 in my program. Fantastic, it did what I expected. That G103 P1 worked fantastic for blocking look ahead over an entire section of code. But sometimes I only have a single macro line that I want to limit look ahead on. For that, we can use one of a handful of codes. An M00 program stop blocks look ahead, meaning that the program does not look past an M0. An M01 op stop blocks look ahead. And incidentally, a forward slash, our block delete, will also limit look ahead. Now, because these codes limit look ahead, none of them can be used inside of a G41 or G42 cutter compensated move. But for the macro programmer, we use them. If I put a forward slash on this line or just before it, my program's not going to execute that in look ahead time. So I've added some forward slashes to my program, and we're going to try this again. Okay, we're back at the control. We're going to check our program once again, this time using a forward slash to limit look ahead. I'm in single block, and I press cycle start. No light, that's a good thing. Light off, light on, light off, light on, program end. It worked just as I expected. Well, you're all set and ready to program macros. Now, typically, look ahead is going to come up when we're programming a counter in our program and we don't want it to get too far ahead, or if we need the program to wait until a fixture clamp is triggered or something like that. We use the high intensity lights as an example, but of course, there's easier ways to turn on and off those lights. Well, that's it, and thanks for watching this Haas Tip of the Day.
We'll be right back.